hands. In my hands, I have the fate and the future of the Ugandan entertainment industry. Jesus is the Lord. My goodness. Anywho, my name is Cynthia Swan, and welcome to Scoop and Scoop, your daily dose of gossip. If it's celebrities and you want to know what time it is or what's happening, I'm your chick. Yes, I am that chick. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Now, as of yesterday, the Stage Plays and Public Entertainments Act came out. Yeah, baby. I know most of you are like, Ebichi. Okay, so there's a petition. Is it a petition? It's an act. They're passing it around to different entertainers and entertainment sects. Reason they're passing it out is that before they can table it down and sit and, you know, sign it or seal it or deliver it or whatever it is that Ugandans say with those legal terms, they wanted the artists who are actually involved in the entertainment scene to first be able to look at them, send it back, and then we see how to pass it. First of all, I didn't even know that we had the Stage Plays and Public Entertainment Act. Did you know about this, Farouk? Like, has it even been there? It's like something they just dreamt up and conjured up. It has a lot of Father Lokodo written on it, if you ask me. I swear, I bet you Father Lokodo is on this. Anyway, this is actually regulations for public entertainment and stage plays, performing artists, event organizers, and promoters in Uganda. That's, of course, for 2018. They wrote 2018, 2019. Kakati, what we are going to be talking about is this particular act. In rules and regulations. First of all, it has been stated that for you to be a performing artist or a performing entertainer or just any part of those sects, guess what you have to do first? You have to register with the Ministry of Gender. I'm like, okay. Every artist will register with their works with Ministry of Gender. Now, the only thing that I got from this and why it made me so happy is that finally artists get to pay. They get to pay taxes, which they have not been paying off them being artists. So it works for the government. It works for the taxpayers out there that felt they have been, these guys have been getting their money very comfortably. None of them, I think, even pays NSSF. None of them pays for anything. And we, the local people who support them, have been paying these taxes on their behalf. So for that, I am extremely excited and happy. Yes, register these artists, register these performers. Let us get what is ours. Tuzimba kumayumba. Imagine. But tubadde tusobola okufa omuntu wa wansi abadde asobola okupayinga taxes ne tuzimba amakubo ge bavuma benyini ba artist ne tuzimba ebifo bye bashootingira mu video naye nga tebateekamu. I mean, this is a good thing. Now let's start. Number one, they are saying every artist shall need a license to operate in Uganda. Wow. How many artists do we have in Uganda? The last time we checked, Farouk, how many artists do we have? Tugatako ba upcoming, tugatako ba acoustics, tugatako ba naba. Because when you say every artist, this clearly states that you have to register underground artists, upcoming artists, already a mainstream artists, acoustic artists. You have to, there are many artists to register anyway. If you fall in any of those categories, guess what? You have to get a license to operate in Uganda. And at number two, they're like, it's illegal to practice public entertainment when you have no license from the ministry. So that goes back to number one, which is also good. No artist shall shoot a music video without permission from the Ministry of Labor. Now, you see, I love my government, I do. But I want to know the idiots who at times sit on these boards. So they are claiming for an artist to shoot a video, you have to first go to the Ministry of Gender, lobby in your concerns. You're like, yes, kusande mbadenjagalan shooting a video. If they feel probably, what? They're going to ask you for your storyline, what the song is about. If they feel it is to par and up to standards, they can let you shoot. Now this, I feel, is encroaching. I feel this is definitely encroaching on the creativity of our artists. It's encroaching on the creativity. That's the key word here, creativity, because we all know how our ministries work. You're going to end up having a bunch of artists lined up at different places, all bribing their way to do something. This I smell a lot of, no. Number three, Njiganye, Ministry of Labor, you shall not. Let's go to number four, though. Let's go to number four. An artist will not perform in more than one venue unless the performance is 4 hours after. Farouk. What is this nyokare? What is this lumpenry? I mean, it makes sense. Like for people like Vic for Mike Ahuka, who always do the same ish. Na kubira ke mbale emisana orogolo na kubira ke mkono orogo emisana no musanga ko echitante orogo. I do get it. I do get where they were trying to come from. But who are the dimwits who sat down and decided to determine for a grown-up person who decided to have a career that you can only shoot after 4 hours? Like, you think about my health even more than I do? Like, you're thinking about my strength? This is pure nyokari, I'm sorry. These are things artists are going to say, no, no. Number four is a definite no, no. And then they go, artist performance time shall not be less than 60 minutes and not more than 120 minutes. What do they mean by that, Farouk? So basically, when you come to stage, the longest you can be on stage is 60 minutes or 120 minutes. How many minutes are those? Let me see, 120 minutes. How many hours are those? It's like 2 hours. Mwe, bagay, Ministry of Gender, Ministry of Labor. Musoke mutubulile. Who sat down and told these people this? Who decided for artists? Is this Balam? Mwme Balam yateno tula na government? Huh? Ona bebe kuru. This is nyokare, this is plain stupidity if you ask me, but hey, what am I to say? I'm just a gossip girl. So your artists are only going to be able to perform for 60 minutes or 120 minutes. That is 2 hours approximately. And on top of performing those 120 minutes or 60 minutes, they are not allowed to perform again until after under 4 hours. Who is going to do that? Who? Let's go on. No artist will perform abroad unless you have permission from the ministry. Oh, Jesus. I don't know, but whoever wrote number six, you clearly had it out for a particular artist. I feel like this one was just written down for Bobby Wine in particular. What is this nonsense? What is this nonsense? I mean, there's regulating an industry. And then there's plain downright, this is like a witch hunt. There's regulating and then there's just, no artist will perform abroad unless if you have permission from the ministry. So let me get this straight. I, Tina, I'm an artist, I'm an individual, right? I take a flight, go to Dubai, probably to chill. While I'm in Dubai, I get a phone call to perform for a particular group of Ugandans. For good money. I will not perform because I have to first come back to Uganda and explain myself to the Ministry of Gender and Labor. What? I mean, there is regulating and then there is sheer stupidity. Is every artist going to have a chaperone from the ministry? I'm just asking. Are we going to have chaperones? My goodness, this is sad. This is sad. At number seven, they're like, no indecently dressed artist will be allowed on stage. I for one, I am standing for this. Bana itubadde tukoye mutu kunamide nyo, mutu kubye bisiranyi binji nyo. I mean, there is dressing up and then there is dressing up. But then again, as much as I am for it and I love the moral side to it, you cannot create, you cannot. I'm going to tell you this because I'm a creative too. You cannot stifle down creativity. And if you are a creative mind or a creative, this not indecently dressed artist, it could cut across many borders. I mean, what is indecent? These laws are not from an educated perspective. They are not from a broadened perspective. They are from someone without an education. They are from someone who is looking to make a quick buck. They are from someone who doesn't understand the world of arts. They are from someone who doesn't understand the world of performing. Arts Interviews One is my Twitter handle, and this time I'd love for you to share your opinions with me, especially the family on YouTube. I know mtenda nyo gendo kumvuma invidi zaba dezitia unakuvumi ye abalamulie umfighting ila Sheila's rights and morals. Msoke mubiteke wasi tuogere tuwaye. You get what I'm saying? At Tina Fierce One, that's on Twitter. On Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and at Tina Fierce One. On Instagram it's at Tina Fierce One with an H. Catch me again tomorrow when it's over. Right, babe, I'm out. Peace.